For Wall Street Media, I'm Mike, I'm here with Doug, and we'll help you make money in the stock market with information you can't find anywhere else.
Because it's ours.
It is.
We own it, and because we're nice people, we share it with you.
Okay, let's go to highlights of conferences. Douglas Poggi, CEO of El Paso, ticker EP, spoke about their 2009 capital program, which will focus on low-risk programs, such as the Haynesville and Altamont Oil. Timothy Wethams, CEO, and Donald DeMare, a COO of Masco Corporation, ticker MAS, announced 31% headcount reduction and closing of South Dakota facility.
Yeah, I saw our buddies at United Technologies today laying off 11,600 mm-hmm. people.
Wow.
Delta laying off 2,100 people.
Mm-hmm.
Office Depot closing 112 North American stores.
Yeah, the economy is going great, right?
It's doing well.
Yeah.
Listen, if you tuned in, the market's up today. Citibank's having a great quarter. That idiot who runs Citibank took $53 billion of yours, your children's, your grandchildren's money, assuming you work, they work, and your grandchildren work, and to stay open for business, mm-hmm. and then had the audacity to come out today and say that they're having a good quarter.
Mm-hmm. I wonder if the company really runs well if you really get rid of every third person. Because there have to be people that know specific things that nobody else knows, right? You would think.
I would think.
Yeah. Well, in other news, Patrick...
But you know what? If they've been doing badly, right. That just means they're going to hurt you less.
Yeah, true. Patrick Connolly, EVP and CMO of Williams-Sonoma, ticker WSM, talks about their plan to reduce inventory by $70 million, capital spending by $100 million, and catalog advertising by $20 million this year, while they expand into direct mail and e-commerce. Brian Campbell, treasurer, and Charles Cleese, a controller of AutoZone, ticker AZO, talked about stimulating commercial sales growth by expanding its hard parts coverage for lot model vehicles.
AutoZone, my buddy Todd Sullivan that we had on yesterday, come to the site and take a look. We've got the video up there from when he was on Fox News Sunday. Is a big proponent of AutoZone. He likes them quite a bit, and he's got really intelligent research. Come to our website. We link to his. He's at valueplays.blogspot.com mm-hmm. and talks about AutoZone. Okay. And he's got some interviews with the CEO.
Mm-hmm. Stephen Reeves, SVP and CFO of Black & Decker Corporation, ticker BDK, talks about 2009 EPS guidance calls for $1.75 to $2.25 on a double-digit organic sales decline expected to last through the third quarter of 2009.
You're Black & Decker, boy.
Yeah,
you have a lot of tools. You're yeah. a smart guy.
Terry Turner, President and CEO, and Harold Carpenter, CFO of Pinnacle Financial Partners, ticker PNFP, talked about their acquisition of Mid-America Bank shares, which has increased their presence with 11 new branches.
GET, in case you didn't watch the other show, bought yesterday. The stock trading is so easy. I can't even believe they give you money for this. bought it yesterday, 5 o'clock, $5 a share. Sold it this morning, $9.40. $6.94 a share, up 40% mm-hmm. in half an hour of the market being open.
You bought
20
the
minutes.
Shares basically because the board of directors changed?
Yes, I did. I saw they were going to have somebody from Mario Gabelli, who is one of my Wall Street idols and icons, a wonderful, elegant, fabulous gentleman. His Gabelli Asset Management Company got someone on the board of Gaylord Entertainment, and also another fund did, and I thought these guys are going to be very proactive in mm-hmm. deriving more value from that rather than having the entrenched management, you know, just say, like, things are good as it is. There's mm-hmm. nothing wrong with that, but these guys own big parts of the company. I knew they would be very active mm-hmm. and value-seeking quickly.
And you just want to get the pop. You didn't want to hold it. You just thought the pop is enough and you get out of it.
I'm in and out, 40%,
mm-hmm.
you know, in 20 yeah. minutes. Could it go up a lot more? Yeah, it could, Mike. But you know what? The rules have all changed. Mm-hmm. Citibank took $53 billion of our money right. and our children's money and then went out and declared they're having a good mm-hmm. quarter.
Yeah. Yeah, I understand.
So I thought...
You'd rather take your profit and
yeah,
you're out.
Yeah. yeah. The rules are
I
changed.
I think that's what a lot of people do nowadays.
That's what Todd Sullivan said on Fox News Sunday,
mm-hmm.
Is that there is more cash sitting on the sideline that's been taken out of the market waiting to go back in, mm-hmm. enough to buy the S&P 500.
Yeah.
He said it's never happened before.
Great. We're here every day at Wall Street Media. You can find us directly at wsmco.com. Thanks.